Testing, testing. 1, 2, 3. Good.
Let fame, that all hunt after in their lives, live registered upon our brazen tombs. Make us heirs of all eternity. Therefore, brave conquerors, for so you are, our late edict shall strongly stand in force. Navarre will be the wonder of the world. Yes, we three, Barone, Dumaine, and myself, have sworn for 3 years' term to live at school, my fellow scholars, and to keep those statutes that are recorded in. Your oaths are passed. And now, subscribe your names. The grosser manner of this world's delights I throw upon the gross world's baser slaves.
I'm resolved. Just put a 3 years fast.
I can but say their protestation over. So much to them I've already sworn. That is to live and study here 3 years. But there are other strict observances. As to not see a woman in that term, which I hope well is not enrolled there. And to one day a week take no food, and to have but one meal on every day beside, and to sleep but 3 hours in the night? No! These are barren tasks, too hard to keep.
I only swore to study with your grace.
You swore to that, Barone, and the rest.
By yea and nay, sir, then I swore in jest. What is the end of study? Let me know.
Why, that's to know which else we should not know.
Things hidden barred, you mean, from common sense?
Aye, that is study's godlike recompense.
Study me how to please the eye, indeed, by fixing it upon fairer eye, who, dazzling so, that eye shall be his heed, and give him light that it was blinded by.
These are the stops that hinder study quite, and train our intellects to vain delight.
Why, all delights are vain, and that most vain which the pain purchased doth inherit pain as painfully to pour upon a book.
Sit you out. Go home, Barone. Adieu.
Give me the paper. Let me read the same, and to the strictest decrees, I'll write my name.
How well this yielding rescues thee from shame.
Item, that no woman shall come within a mile of my court. Hath this been proclaimed?
4 days ago.
On pain of losing her tongue. Who hath devised this?
Mary, that did I.
Sweet lord, and why?
To fright thee hence with that dread penalty.
If any man be seen to talk with a woman within the term of 3 years, they shall... This article, my liege, you yourself must break. For well you know, here comes in embassy the French king's daughter, with yourself to speak of her decrepit, sick, and bedrid father?
We must of force dispense with this decree. She must lie here of mere necessity.
Necessity will make us all forsworn 3,000 times in this 3 years space.
For every man with his affects born, not by might mastered, but by special grace. So, to the laws at large, I write my name. And I believe, although I seem so loath, I am the last that last will keep his oath.
just wanna do something special for all the ladies in the world.
Oh yes.
Just wanna do something special for all the ladies in the world. And the girls, don't forget them.
Caribbean
girls. Ladies.
Parisian.
Ladies.
Bolivia.
Ladies.
Namibia.
Ladies.
Eastern Indochinian.
Ladies.
Republic of Dominican.
Now, madam, remember who the king your father sends, to whom he sends, and what's his embassy. Yourself, held precious in the world's esteem, to parlay as the sole inheritor of all perfections that a man may own.
Okay.
No woman may approach the silent court.
Therefore, to seem to fit
tell him that the daughter of the King of France, on serious business, craving a quick dispatch, importunes personal conference with his grace. Haste signifies so much while we attend like humble visaged suitors his high will. Who are the votaries, my loving lords, that are vow fellow with this virtuous duke?
The young Dumaine, a well accomplished youth. I saw him at the Duke Allenson's once, and much too little of that good I saw as my report to his great worthiness.
Barone, they call him. His eye begets occasion of his wit, for every object that one doth catch, the other turn to a mirth-moving jest.
God bless, my ladies. Are you in love?
Navarre had notice of your fair approach, and he and his competitors in oath were all addressed to meet you before I came. Gentle lady. Mary, this much I have learned. He rather means to lodge you in the field.
Like one who comes here to besiege his court. Back again and welcome, I have not yet.
Hear me, dear lady, I have sworn an oath.
Our lady help, my lord, he'll be forsworn.
Not for the world, fair madam, by my will.
Why, will shall break it, will and nothing else.
Your ladyship is ignorant what it is.
Were my lord so, his ignorance were wise, where now his knowledge must prove ignorance. Oh, but pardon me, I'm too sudden bold.
Did I not dance with you in Brabant once?
Did I not dance with you in Brabant once?
Well, I know you did.
How needless was it then to ask the question?
You must not be so quick.
'Tis long of you that spur me with such questions.
Your wit's too hot, it speeds too fast, 'twill tire.
Not before it leaves the rider in the mire.
Yet there remains unpaid 100,000 more, in surety of the which one part of Aquitaine is bound to us.
What time of day?
The hour that fools should ask.
Guys.
Thank you.
You may not, fair ladies, stay within our gates, but you shall deem yourselves lodged in our hearts. Tomorrow we shall visit you again.
Psst. Lady, I will commend you to my own heart.
Pray you, do my commendations. I shall be glad to see it.
Oh, would you heard it groan?
Oh, is the fool sick?
Sick at the heart.
Alack, let it blood.
I beseech thee, a word. What is she in the light?
A woman, and you saw her in the light.
I desire a name.
She has but one for herself. To desire that were a shame.
Pray you, sir, whose daughter?
Her mother's, I have heard. Good sir, be not offended. She is an heir to Falconbridge.
Nay, my collar is ended. She is the most sweet lady.
What's her name? Sir, in the black.
Rosaline, my good fact.
Is she wedded or no?
To her will, sir, or so.
You are welcome, sir. Adieu.
Farewell to me, sir, and welcome to you.
Lovers entitled affection.
Your reason?
Their tongues all impatient to speak and not see. Their faces' own margins did quote such amazes that all eyes saw their eyes enchanted with gazes.
Come to our pavilion, Boyette is disposed.
I only make a mouth of his eye by adding a tongue which I know will not lie.
Thou art an old lovemonger and speakest skillfully.
Do you hear, mad wenches?
No.
Sweet a kiss the golden sun gives not to those fresh morning drops upon the rose. As thy eye beams when their fresh rays have smote the night of dew that on my cheeks down flows. Nor shines the silver moon one half so bright through thy transparent bosom of the deep, as doth thy face through tears of mine give light. Thou shinest in every tear that I do weep. No drop but as a coach doth carry thee, so ridest thou triumphing in my woe. Do but behold the tears that swell in me. And they thy glory through my grief will show. But do not love thyself, then thou wilt keep my tears for glasses.
I, forsooth, in love?
Mm-mm.
I, that have been love's whip? A very beadle to a humorous sigh. A critic. Nay, a night watch constable. A domineering pedant or the boy.
This wimple, whining, purblind, wayward boy. This senior junior, giant dwarf. Dan Cupid!
Regent of love rhymes, lord of folded arms, the anointed sovereign of sighs and groans. And I, to be a corporal of his field and wear his colors like a tumbler's hoop?
What?
I love?
I sue?
I seek a wife? A woman. That is like a German clock. Still a repairing, ever going out of frame, never going aright, being a watch. But being watched, that they may still go right.
Nay, to be perjured, which is worst of all.
And among greed. To love the worst of all? A whitely wanton with a velvet brow and two pitch balls in her face for eyes?
Aye, and by heaven, one that would do the deed.
And I to sigh for her?
To watch for her?
Pray for her?
Go to!
It is a plague that Cupid will impose for my neglect of his almighty dreadful little might.
I will love.
Right?
Sigh.
Pray.
Sue?
Hello?
Some men must love my lady, and some Joan. By the Lord, this love is as mad as Ajax. It kills sheep. It kills me. I, a sheep. Well proved, wit. I will not love. If I do, hang me. In faith, I will not. Oh, by heaven, I do love. And it hath taught me to rhyme and be melancholy. By the world, I would not care a pin if the other two were in.
I mean.
Shot by heaven.
So sweet a kiss the golden sun gives not to those fresh morning drops upon the rose. As thy eye beams, when their fresh rays have smote the night of dew that on my cheeks down flows. Nor shines the silver moon one half so bright through the trans.
Now, in thy likeness, one more fool appear.
Ay me, I am forsworn. O glorious Kate, once more I shall read the ode I have writ.
Once more, all mark how love can vary wit.
On a day, alack the day, love, whose month is ever May, spied a blossom passing fair, playing in the wanton air. Through the velvet leaves the wind, all unseen can passage find, that the lover, sick to death, wished himself the heaven's breath. Air, quoth he, thy cheeks may blow, air would I might triumph so. But alack, my hand is sworn.
I heard your guilty rhymes, observed your fashion, saw sighs reek from you, noted well your passion. I, me, was one. Oh, Jove was another. What will Barone say when that he hears? How he will scorn, how he will spend his wit.
Now step forth I to whip hypocrisy. Good heart, what grace hast thou thus to reprove this worm for loving that art most in love? You'll not be perjured, 'tis a hateful thing, but are you not all ashamed?
Too bitter is thy jest. Are we betrayed thus to thy overview?
I am betrayed by keeping company with men like you, men of inconstancy. I that am honest. I that consider it a sin to break the vow that I am engaged in. When will you hear me say a thing in rhyme, or groan for Joan, or spend a minute's time?
So, whither away so fast? A true man or a thief that gallops so?
I post from love. Good lover, let me go.
What present hast thou there?
Barone, read it over.
A toy, my liege, a toy. Good friends, you need not fear it.
Well, it did move him to passion, therefore let's hear it.
It is in Barone's writing, and it hath his name.
Guilty. I confess.
And now the number is even.
True. We are three.
Sweet lords. Sweet lovers. Oh, let us embrace.
Forsooth, of our hands must be forsworn.
My eyes are then no eyes, nor I Barone. Oh, but for my love, day would turn to night.
My love, her mistress, is a gentle moon.
Beauty doth varnish age as if newborn.
Oh, 'tis the sun that maketh all things shine.
But we have made a vow to study, lords, and in that vow we have forsworn our books.
But love, first learned in a lady's eyes, it adds a precious seeing to the eye. A lover's eyes will gaze an eagle blind, and a lover's ear will hear the lowest sound.
Never durst poet touch pen to write, until his ink were tempered with lover's eyes.
From women's eyes, this doctrine have I devised.
They are the books. The arts, the academes that show, contain, and nourish all the world.
Let us lose our oaths to find ourselves, or else we lose ourselves to keep our oaths.
Saint Cupid, then, and soldiers to the field.
Well, shall we resolve to woo these girls of France?
And win them, too. Therefore, let us devise some entertainment for them in their tents!
Look you what I have from the loving king.
Madam, come nothing along with that?
Nothing but this? Yes, as much love in rhyme as would be crammed up in a sheet of paper, writ of both sides, leave margins and all. But Rosalind, you have a favor too.
I would you knew. And if my face were but as fair as yours, my favors were as great. Be witness this. Ooh. Oh, nay, I have verses too. I thank Barone. Oh, he hath drawn a picture in his letter.
Anything like?
Much in the letters, nothing in the praise.
But Catherine, what have you from Fair Dumain?
Yes, madam, and moreover, some thousand verses of a faithful lover. A huge translation of hypocrisy, vilely compiled, profound simplicity.
We are wise girls to mock our lovers so.
They are worse fools to purchase mocking so. That same Barone I'll torment ere I go.
None are so surely caught when catched as wit turned fools.
Oh, I'm stabbed with laughter.
Madam, prepare. Love doth approach disguised. The king and his companions will by and by disguised. They will be here like Muscovites or Russians, as I guess. Their purpose? To court, to parley, and to dance. And every man his love feet shall advance.
And will they so? The gallants have been tasked, for we shall everyone be masked. And not a man of them shall have the grace, despite of suit, to see a lady's face.
But in this disguise, what is your intent?
The effect of my intent is to cross theirs. They do but in mockery merriment, and mock for mock is my intent.
But shall we dance if they desire us to it?
No, to the death we shall not move a foot, nor to their penned words shall we render no grace. But while 'tis spoke, each shall turn away her face.
But I want you like that. Yeah, I want you like that. Yeah, I want you. Yeah, I want you. Yeah, I want you like that. Say you're just a friend, I'm a little liar. When we play pretend, body is on fire. Cause I like it like that. Yeah, I like it like that. Yeah, I like it. Yeah, I like it. Yeah, I like it like that. Got the risk of getting caught. Wanna taste for
beauties on the earth.
What would you with the princess?
Nothing but peace and gentle visitation.
What would they say?
Nothing but peace and gentle visitation.
What that they have and bid them so be gone.
She says you have it and may be gone.
Say to her.
She hears herself.
We have measured many miles to tread a measure with you on this grass.
How many weary steps of how many weary miles you have o'ergone are numbered in the travel of 1 mile?
We measure nothing we spend for you.
My face is but a moon, and clouded too.
Vouchsafe, bright moon, and these thy stars to shine.
Play music then, nay, you must do it soon.
It's been said and done. Every beautiful thought that I saw. And I guess
not yet. No dance. Thus change I like the moon.
Will you not dance? How come you thus estranged?
You took the moon in full, but now she's changed.
The music plays. Vouchsafe some motion to it.
Our ears vouchsafe it.
But your legs should do it.
All right, all right. Since you are strangers and come here by chance, we'll not be nice. Take hands, we will not dance.
Why take we hands then?
only to part as friends. Curtsy, sweetheart, and so this measure ends.
Oh, more measure of this measure. Be not nice.
We can afford no more at such a price.
Prize yourselves. What buys your company?
Your absence only.
That cannot be.
And then can no more we be bought, and so adieu.
If you deny to dance,
let us hold more chat.
In private, then.
Mocking wenches are as keen as is the razor's edge, invisible.
No, please, enough, please, enough, enough. Not one word more, my ladies. Break off, break off.
By heaven, all dry leaving, pierce scoff.
Farewell, mad wenches. You have simple wits.
Well, liking wits they have. Gross, gross, fat, fat. They were all in lamentable cases.
The king, my love, hath sworn. I think Barone hath plighted faith to me.
Just as Domain was to my service born.
Madam! Pretty mistresses, give me your...
All hail, sweet madam. And fair time of day. We came to visit you, but purpose now to bring you to our court.
This court shall not hold me, and so hold your word, nor God nor I delights in perjured men.
The virtue of your eyes must break my oath. You have lived in desolation here, unseen, unvisited, much to our shame.
Not so, my lord, it is not so. A mess of Russians left us but of late.
How? Russians?
Aye, in truth, my lord. Trim gallants, full of courtship and of state.
Here they stayed but an hour, and in it did not bless us with one happy word.
We dare not call them fools, but this we think.
Which one of the vizards was it that you wore?
Where? When? What vizard? Why ask you this?
There, then, that vizard, that superfluous case.
Good. You were discreet, but mock us downright. Let us confess and turn into a jest.
Amazed, my lord? Why looks your highness sad?
Help, hold his brows, he'll swoon. Why look you so pale?
Seasick, I think, coming from Muscovy.
Here stand I, lady. Dart thy skill at me. Thrust thy sharp wit quite through my ignorance. Yet I have a trick of the old rage. Bear with me. I am sick. They have the plague, the cottard of your eyes. Our states are forfeit, but seek not to undo us.
It is not so. This can't be true, that you stand forfeit, being those that sue.
My wit is at an end. Speak for yourselves.
The fairest confession. Were not you here, but even now disguised?
Madam, I was.
And were you well advised?
I was, fair madam.
When you were here, what did you whisper in your lady's ear?
More than the world, I did respect her.
Peace. Peace, forbear. Your oath once broke, you force not to forswear.
Despise me if I break this oath of mine.
I will, and therefore keep it. Rosalind, what did the Russian whisper in your ear?
That he would wed me, or else die my lover.
God give thee joy of him. The noble lord most honorably doth uphold his word.
I did not swear this oath.
You gave me these. But take them back again, sir.
And Lord Dumain is my dear.
I see the trick on it. Here was consent, knowing aforehand of our merriment, to dash it like a Christmas comedy.
To our perjury, to add more terror, we are again forsworn in will and error.
Welcome, monsieur. Wilt thou interrupt us our merriment? D-
dead by my life.
How fares your majesty?
Boyette, prepare. I will await tonight.
Not so, madam. I do beseech you, stay.
Prepare, I say. I thank you, gracious lords.
For your fair sakes, we have neglected time, made foul our oaths.
Your beauty hath much deformed us, ladies, fashioning our humors even to the opposite end of our intents.
We have received your letters full of love, your favors the ambassador of love, and in our maiden council write them at courtship, pleasant jest, and courtesy, in their own fashion like a merriment.
Our favors showed much more than jest,
and so our looks.
We did not quote them so.
Now at the latest minute of the hour, grant us your love.
A time methinks too short. Your oath I will not trust, but go with speed to some naked and forlorn hermitage, remote from all the pleasures of this world. If this austere, insociable life change not your offer made in heat of blood, if frosts and fasts, hard lodging and thin weeds nip not the gaudy blossoms of your love, then at the expiration of this year come challenge me. Challenge me by these deserts, and I will be thine.
Hence, hermit, my heart is in thy breast.
Well, what to me, my love? What to me? The wife?
Twelve month in a day, I'll mark no words smooth-faced wooers say. Come when the king doth to my lady, come. And if I have much love, I'll give you some, yet swear not, lest you be forsworn again.
I'll serve thee true and faithfully till then.
Impose some service on me for thy love.
Oft have I heard of you, my lord Barone, before I saw you. And the world's large tongue proclaims you for a man replete with mocks. You shall, this 12-month period, from day to day, visit the speechless sick, and still converse with all the fierce endeavor of your wit, to enforce the painted impotent to smile.
I'll jest a 12-month in a hospital. Our wooing doth not end like an old play. Jack hath not Jill. These ladies' courtesy might well have made our sport a comedy.
Come, sir. Once a 12-month and a day, and then 'twill end.
That's too long for a play. Tom, it needs to stay there.
Why?
Because it might be in a shot.
I wanted to see who was running the world.
Run the world! Girls! Run the world! Girls!
who run the world.
Girls!
We run this mother.
Boom, boom.
We run this mother.
Boom, boom.
Who run the world.
Girls!
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 We run this mother.
Boom, boom.
We run... world.
Girls!
Who run the world?
Girls!
We run this mother.
Bum bum!
We run this mother.
Bum bum!
Who run the world?
Girls!
Who run the world?
Girls!
We run this mother.
Bum bum!
We run this mother.
Bum bum!
Who run the world?
Girls!